climate is changing. That is a fact that is not disputed. But how much is it changing? In past videos, we explained that although climate change occurs naturally on our planet, human activities are accelerating it. This implies that processes that would naturally have taken thousands of years will occur within 5 decades. But what events could we expect in 50 years due to climate change? Keep watching to find out. Number 5. Melting glaciers and sea level rise. Melting glaciers and the consequent rise in sea level are phenomena that we are already observing, and that due to climate change are expected to intensify in the coming decades. The two areas most vulnerable to this are the Earth's poles. At the North Pole, we have Greenland. This area is home to the world's second largest ice sheet, and its ice loss rate has accelerated dramatically in recent decades. A study published in Nature 2020 revealed that Greenland lost about 3.8 trillion tons of ice between 1992 and 2018, contributing about 10.6 millimeters to global sea level rise. Rising air and ocean temperatures primarily drive this melting. According to the IPCC, if greenhouse gas emissions continue at the current rate, Greenland could contribute between 5 and 10 centimeters to sea level rise by 2100. At the South Pole, we have the Antarctic ice sheet, which is also experiencing rapid disintegration. Research shows that this region lost about 2.7 trillion tons of ice between 1992 and 2017, according to a NASA report. The melting in Antarctica is primarily due to warming ocean waters undermining glaciers from below, causing them to slide more quickly into the sea. If the entire West Antarctic sheet were to melt, the global sea level would rise by about 3 meters. Although this extreme scenario is not likely over the 50-year horizon, the IPCC estimates that Antarctica's contribution to sea level rise could be as much as 12 centimeters by 2100, depending on humanity's future greenhouse gas emissions. Sea level rise affects coastal ecosystems, including habitats of key species such as mangroves, coral reefs, and salt marshes. These ecosystems provide essential services such as storm protection and support for biodiversity. Flooding and salinization of these habitats can lead to the loss of species and the decline of ecosystems. If that is not enough, rising sea levels directly threaten more than 600 million people living in coastal areas. In addition, rising sea levels increase the frequency and severity of flooding, erode coastlines, and pollute freshwater sources with salt water. Cities like Miami, New York, and Tokyo would be at significant risk. Continuous observation of current trends and the most reliable climate models indicate that melting glaciers and thus sea level rise will continue to be one of the main consequences of climate change over the next 50 years. Number 4. Ecosystem changes and species extinction. Climate change is causing significant alterations in ecosystems and accelerating species extinction at an alarming rate. The alteration of natural habitats, the modification of behavior patterns, and the impossibility of adapting quickly to climate changes are factors that contribute to the loss of biodiversity. Two areas of the world are especially vulnerable to this, and unfortunately, they are places with incalculable value. The first is the Great Barrier Reef. This is the largest coral reef system in the world, has been listed as the largest living thing on the planet, and is visible from space. However, climate change has severely affected this complex ecosystem because corals are susceptible to water temperatures. A degree Celsius more or less does not affect humans, but it does immense damage to reefs. Rising ocean temperatures have led to massive coral bleaching events, during which corals expel the symbiotic algae that provide them with nutrients and color. Without these algae, corals turn white, and if heat stress persists, they die quickly. Between 2016 and 2017, the Great Barrier Reef experienced two consecutive mass bleaching events, affecting more than 50% of corals. According to a study published in Nature, the frequency and intensity of these events have increased dramatically, and it is expected that if greenhouse gas emissions continue at the current rate, mass bleaching events could occur annually by 2050, completely devastating this area of the world, causing irreparable damage. If the barrier reef disappears, all the plants and animals that depend on it will also disappear, and it will be the end for thousands of aquatic creatures. The second place is the Amazon rainforest, known as the lungs of the planet. This vast ecosystem stores large amounts of carbon and is home to unparalleled biodiversity. However, rising temperatures and changes in precipitation patterns are affecting forest health. A study by Brazil's National Institute for Space Research, INPE, indicated that the Amazon is experiencing more severe and frequent droughts every year, which increases the risk of wildfires. Wildfires destroy large areas of forest and release vast amounts of carbon into the atmosphere. Deforestation combined with climate change could lead to a point of no return, where large parts of the Amazon become savanna, with a massive loss of biodiversity and the extinction of hundreds or even thousands of species of plants and animals. The probability that changes in these and other ecosystems will occur in the next 50 years is extremely high. According to the most recent records, approximately 150 species of plants and animals are becoming extinct every day worldwide. 150 species that are with us today and tomorrow will no longer be, and this will continue unless we do something. The scientific community, including the IPCC and conservation organizations, warns that we are experiencing a sixth mass extinction, primarily driven by human activity. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Number 3. Alteration of hydrological cycles. Climate change is profoundly impacting the Earth's hydrological cycles, affecting the distribution and availability of water in various regions of the world. This phenomenon manifests itself mainly through changes in precipitation patterns, increasing the frequency and severity of droughts and floods. Let's observe the two most extreme sides of this phenomenon. First, we have the Horn of Africa, which includes countries such as Somalia, Ethiopia, and Kenya. This region has experienced recurrent and severe droughts in recent decades. This region has witnessed at least 4 severe droughts since 2005, affecting millions of people. According to the World Food Program, WFP, the 2011 drought in Somalia led to a famine that affected 13 million people and caused the deaths of approximately 260,000 people. An IPCC report notes that the likelihood of extreme droughts in this region has increased due to climate change. Reduced rainfall and rising temperatures reduce water availability for agriculture and human consumption, worsening food insecurity and causing mass population displacements. Next, we have the opposite side of the coin, Southeast Asia, a densely populated region that includes countries such as Thailand, Vietnam, and the Philippines, is facing an increase in the frequency and severity of floods. In 2011, Thailand suffered one of the worst floods in its history, which affected approximately 13 million people. Increased extreme rainfall and rising sea levels associated with climate change contribute to flooding in Southeast Asia. The IPCC projects that extreme rainfall will become more frequent in this region as the climate worsens, increasing the risk of flooding. Alterations in hydrological cycles have devastating effects on ecosystems. In the case of droughts in the Horn of Africa, reduced rainfall and water scarcity affect local vegetation and wildlife. On the other hand, floods in Southeast Asia can destroy terrestrial and aquatic habitats, killing species and dispersing animal populations. In addition, water currents laden with sediment and pollutants can damage coral reefs and mangroves, which are crucial for marine biodiversity and coastal protection. The IPCC's climate models indicate that precipitation patterns will become more erratic as global temperatures continue to rise in 50 years. Semi-arid and arid regions, such as the Horn of Africa, will face more severe droughts, while areas prone to heavy rainfall, such as Southeast Asia, will increase flooding. Another consequence of these changes can be seen today in the Panama Canal, one of the most important freight crossings in the world. Due to the lack of rainfall, the canal's capacity has been reduced. If this continues, all maritime transport must opt for new trade routes. Would you like us to talk more about what's going on with the Panama Canal? Let us know in the comments. Number 2. Challenges in energy production. Alterations in weather patterns affect both renewable and non-renewable energy generation, threatening the stability and efficiency of the energy supply. This phenomenon manifests itself mainly through changes in the availability of water resources, rising temperatures, and the frequency of extreme weather events. Let's start with the apparent hydroelectric capacity. South America's population is heavily dependent on hydropower, which accounts for approximately 60% of its electricity production. However, climate change is altering precipitation patterns and reducing water availability for hydroelectric dams. A report by the Inter-American Development Bank, IDB, highlights that hydroelectric capacity in the region could decrease by 10% and 20% by 2050 due to the decrease in glacier mass and rainfall variability. In countries like Brazil, which gets more than 70% of its electricity from hydroelectric sources, prolonged drought has already significantly impacted power generation. In 2014-2015, Brazil experienced one of the worst droughts in decades, drastically reducing hydroelectric production and forcing the country to rely more on fossil energy sources, thereby increasing carbon emissions. It should also be considered that nuclear and coal-fired power plants rely on water to cool their systems. Rising global temperatures and extreme heat waves can reduce the efficiency of these plants, and in some cases, force them to reduce or stop production. In Europe, the 2003 heat wave led to a significant reduction in nuclear power production, as high water temperatures made cooling less efficient, and in some cases, impossible, without violating environmental regulations on discharge temperature. A study by the Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research, PIK, estimates that by 2050, nuclear and coal-fired power plants in Europe could reduce generation capacity by 6% and 19% due to a lack of adequate cooling water and rising temperatures. Reduced hydropower capacity and rising water temperatures have direct effects on aquatic ecosystems. Hydroelectric dams, when operating with less water, can alter the natural flows of rivers, affecting species that depend on certain levels of water for their reproduction and feeding. The reduction in the flow of rivers can negatively affect wetlands and the species that inhabit them, causing displacement or, in the worst case, the extinction of species, as in the case of Beiji. This freshwater dolphin became extinct after the massive Three Gorges Dam was built in China. The likelihood that these challenges in energy production will intensify over the next 50 years is very high. So, the question is not whether this could happen. The real question is, will we be ready for when it happens? Number 1. Increase in the frequency and intensity of natural disasters. As we have mentioned in other videos, climate change is associated with increased frequency and intensity of natural disasters such as hurricanes, wildfires, floods, and heat waves. These extreme events have devastating effects on ecosystems and humanity. In recent decades, an increase in the intensity and frequency of hurricanes in the Atlantic has been observed. According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, the 2020 hurricane season was the most active on record, with 30 named storms, 13 hurricanes, and 6 major hurricanes. Rising sea temperatures provide more energy for forming more powerful hurricanes. Hurricane Maria in 2017 is a clear example of the devastating impacts of these phenomena. Maria reached Category 5 status and caused massive destruction in Puerto Rico, resulting in more than 3,000 deaths and damage that remains unrepaired today. Conversely, Australia has experienced increasingly severe brush fires, a trend that is clearly linked to climate change. The 2019-2020 fire season, known as the Black Summer, was one of the worst on record, with approximately 186,000 square kilometers burned, 33 people killed, and around 3,000 homes destroyed. Scientific studies, such as those published by the Australia Climate Council, have pointed out that rising temperatures and drier conditions are increasing the length and intensity of fire seasons. Wildfires devastate ecosystems, kill millions of animals, and destroy critical habitats. In the black summer, it is estimated that about 3 billion animals died or were displaced. Natural disasters have devastating effects on ecosystems. Hurricanes can destroy coral reefs, mangroves, and coastal forests, crucial for biodiversity and coastal protection. Wildfires, on the other hand, not only kill humans and destroy their habitats, but also disrupt nutrient cycles and can change the structure and composition of forests in the long term. These ecosystems' recovery can take decades, and in some cases, they may never return to their original state. The increase in the frequency and intensity of natural disasters represents a monumental challenge for humanity. The most intense and frequent hurricanes can destroy critical infrastructure, cause enormous economic losses, and lead to humanitarian crises. IPCC reports and other scientific studies indicate that as global temperatures continue to rise, it is likely that in 50 years, or even less, we will see an increase in the frequency and intensity of these extreme events. Hotter and drier weather conditions and rising sea levels will create an environment ripe for increasingly severe natural disasters. Do you think humanity is ready to face any of these possible events? Let us know what you think in the comments.